welcome back to XGate Dental. I'm Emmanuel Kadosh, and we are here to discuss new procedures in the field of dentistry. We will provide interesting new cases to exhibit how doctors use our products to solve complicated dental cases, so don't forget to subscribe and follow. Today we brought a case where we restored the left upper part, and we had one implant that was placed a really long time ago. The implants on the canine and the other implants were newly placed. So the single implant had a cemented crown for many years. And later on, we wanted to use this implant and add some other implants also for the zirconia bridge screw retained. We wanted to use the implant. So one of the options was to leave it with the cemented crown. And this way we'll have a single crown and a small bridge. Or we could make a bridge that is a little bigger with one more crown and it would be one bulk. So here we can see the bridge from the occlusion part. This is probably PMMA and is a temporary bridge. You have two molars, two premolars, and the canine. In the canine, you have the implant, and here you have three more implants. This molar looks kind of broken, and possibly because of her occlusion, the original tooth was worn off or broken. So now, if we want to restore with a new crown, it couldn't be a fully functional crown because she can't close her mouth. She had a broken tooth, and now the crown will probably be the same with an anatomic design. She can't have a fully new crown with a knot worn off. If you have a patient and you're only changing some of the teeth, you can't leave the other teeth worn off and the new teeth with fully anatomical structures. So this is why when you change molars, the anatomical design that you have in the end will probably be close to the original one that you had. So if she had a worn off molar, the crown would be the same way. The regional design probably will stay the same or close to it. Here you can see three implants and one where the molar is. The second one is the first molar, then you have the first premolar and the old implant for the canine. Originally, here she had teeth and only the canine was extracted and replaced with an implant. She had a cemented restoration, cemented crown on this implant, and now we want to change it to screw retained restoration. The implant was placed in this type of angulation, and with this angulation, it's very hard to have a very aesthetical screw retained restoration. It's much simpler to make a cemented crown. This is why when it was a single crown, we made a cemented restoration. Now we want to change this crown and we want to add some other implants so we can have a screw retained restoration and not one cemented and one screw retained. Now, why was the V-type used? Well, the implant is angulated, so we need to put an angulated abutment or angulated multi-unit to correct the angulation of the implant. But in this case, you can see that the height of the gingiva is very low and it's very small. So if you use an angulated multi-unit, you'll have this part of the multi-unit outside the gingiva. It will be very hard to mask it and you lose all of these aesthetical aspects of the crown. Half of the crown will be metal and you will see all of it. So this is why in this case, when we have an angulated multi-unit with angulated implant and a very low height of gingiva, we'll want to use a straight multi-unit. And we even prefer not to screw to those multi-units and just use them as stoppers and use the other implants. We have enough implants for this bridge. This canine, you have a quite adjacent implant to the canine. You have the rigidity for the bridge. You just want some of the forces to be distributed to the implant. That way you won't see any metal. Now, if we had only two implants for this bridge, it wouldn't be possible to use one of them as a stopper. So you'll need to find a way to connect this. Maybe you'll have a cemented bridge, but in this case, you can change it to screw retained and use a straight multi-unit with a stopper and not use an angulated one. The angulated ones, you almost always have a problem in the aesthetical aspect of it if it's a frontal area because the buccal part of the angulated implant is almost always visible when you don't have enough height of the gingiva. And in this case, you can see the stopper. You can see we have three screw channels. You can see all of the screw channels are very small and we have the screw inside of the bridge. We use the 3 or 4 millimeter sleeves and one stopper. The stopper itself is about 1.5 millimeters, so it doesn't have any height at all. You just cement the stopper to the bridge, and all of the vertical forces will go onto this bridge, onto this crown, on the canine, and this will be applied on the multi-unit. When you use a small screw channel for the bridge, the amount of occlusion surface that's left is much bigger. So in this case, the smallest screw channel is about half in the surface, and then the bigger screw channel, and you'll have all of the occlusion parts of the crown. And the crown itself, for example, when using material like zirconia or even PFM, you have more space for metal or more space for the zirconia. The crown is much stronger, even on the PFM. This way we close the screw channels with temporary pins, then you cut the pin, and this is the bridge that you have in the end. You can see that for the canine, you don't have any screw channels, although we have a screw-retained implant. We have a multi-unit, and we have a stopper, and we have a sleeve that acts like a stopper on the canine itself. Then we had the first implant in the first premolar area, the second and the third in the molar area. This is the diameter of the screw channel. You can see that it almost doesn't affect the occlusion surface. And here you have a defect in the bones. So it was impossible to place an implant, but for a 5-crown bridge on 3 implants is quite enough. You don't need any more. It's a great solution for some cases when you can't have any other solution. If you have enough distribution of forces and if you have enough implants that there are many downsides to using a stopper, if you didn't have an implant in the area of the first premolar, you can't use a stopper. You can have 2 molars and then a 3-crown cantilever. It all depends. It's there to help solve different cases and not as a regular thing that you want to use. In regular cases, you want to have quite parallel implants. You want to have the screw channel in the occlusion area, and in this case, we have one implant that was placed a very long time ago. It was angulated, and then later on, we placed 3 implants quite parallelly. You can see the screw channels are almost exactly in the center of the crown, perfectly positioned implants, and still, we want to have screw-retained restoration, and we use the old one. But you can't put a healing cap or screw cover on the implant and then close the implant and forget about it. But why not use it if you can use the implant in some way that will help you if it's in good condition? Regardless, thank you everyone that joined in to learn some new and interesting information. Make sure to stay tuned for more. And of course, don't forget to subscribe, like, and follow. Thank you guys, and see you next time.